Today we're looking at the top 10 biggest scams in history. Welcome to Alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. Welcome, Aluxers, to today's video where we're going to share with you the 10 biggest scams in history. They're super shocking and some are pretty surprising. There are lies and lots of deceit, and here we focus on the biggest scams that have hit the news over many decades. Bankers, con artists, and fraudsters alike, here's the top 10 list where investors have been left isolated and some of the crimes have ended up affecting some of the most prevalent economies. Without further ado, let's take a look at the top 10 biggest scams in history. If you're new here, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and follow us on Instagram at Alux. Number 10. Alves Dos Reis. Total scammed $1.3 million. 1925 was not the first year that Alves Dos Reis was in trouble with the law. While in prison in 1924, Reis decided to come up with another plan widely known as the Portugal Banknote Affair. Reis's idea was to scam companies into making false money. He cleverly came up with a plan to convince a London-based company to print the equivalent of 1,007,963 British pounds. However, in a not-so-bright state, Reis didn't think that the low interest rate would absorb such a wide audience. The media and their journalists became more increasingly interested in the Bank of Angola and Metropole, busting Reis of his scam, resulting in him being imprisoned for another 20 years. Number 9. Bre-X's Gold Mine. Total scammed $4 million. It was during the late 1990s that John Felderhoff had convinced himself there was a property near to the Busang River that was able to produce gold after mining. From this advice, a geologist named Michael deGuzman took over the project but was unable to find any traces of gold. The scam comes from the fact that this sly Filipino geologist decided to shave some of the gold from one of his rings, saying he found it on the site, and declared that the amount of 62 tons was found there. It was down to this choice that Bre-X's property began to increase in popularity as mining investors from all around the world chose to invest in huge amounts. In 1997, when the scam was found out, deGuzman committed suicide and jumped from an airplane. Number 8. Charles Ponzi. Total scammed $10 million. The Ponzi Scheme. Ponzi was bright, and he knew it. Taking advantage of investors and playing them off against each other to make a profit for himself, Ponzi was definitely not stupid at all. Beginning using the technique in 1920, his name has now become popular among similar con artists. As talented as the Ponzi scheme is, it usually is busted pretty quickly due to three common things. 1. The operator eventually vanishes, taking all of the profit with them. 2. The economy changes, meaning that some investors had to back down early and didn't carry on with the commitment to the deal. And 3, if the number of recent investors drops, the operator then has trouble paying back the returns promised initially due to a lack of investors being able to commit. Number 7. Ivar Kreugar. Total scammed $142 million. Helping to build the new Plaza Hotel, Ivar Kreugar was a famous man in New York. In 1908, he opened his own company, which was one of the most popular construction companies going in Sweden. However, it wasn't until after Kreugar died that the extent of his scam came to light. After offering loans to bankrupt companies, a deal very appealing, Kreugar's forged Italian bonds that he had created got found out in Sweden. Remarkably, it's recorded that because of this bust, the suicide rate went up in the country, and they also lost their prime minister. It was a total disaster. Number 6. Emmanuel Nwude. Total scammed $242 million. It was 3 years after the deed that Emmanuel Nwude was found out for his scam. It was in 1998 when the Spanish bank decided to look into Nwude's significant figures, which were sitting in the Cayman Islands, unmonitored. Nwude's scam was something of a gem. He decided to convince a Brazilian man, Nelson Sakaguchi, to invest in a new airport that was going to open in 1995. However, little did Sakaguchi know that this airport didn't even exist, and that Nwude had made the entire thing up. And Aluxers, if you're liking this video, maybe we can interest you in another one, but this time, a legitimate one. Here's 15 ways to make $10 million. If that sounds interesting, click in the top right corner. Number 5. Joseph Nacchio. Total scammed $3 billion. Despite his knowledge that the company was heading for the gutter, Joseph Nacchio decided to continue to sell off high revenue targets to Wall Street. Despite knowing these companies were never going to reach their peak target, Nacchio continued to convince people earning over $2.5 billion. In 2009, Nacchio finally got sentenced with 19 counts of insider trading and was forced to pay over $19 million in fines and over $53 million to the illegal stock trading. What a bold man indeed. Not quite bright enough to get away with his scheme, though. Number 4. Charles Keating. Total scammed, $5.5 billion. Revealed in 1989, Charles Keating's scam was something that many people were disgusted by. He had sold worthless bonds to many elderly residents. Being the head of Lincoln Savings and Loan Association, Keating was well known to many while also being a fantastic swimmer, lawyer, and real estate developer. Keating's business went bankrupt in the year the scam was exposed. It turns out that he had been taking advantage of the loose restrictions on banking investments. He began investing his depositors' money in unsolicited deals while falsifying information. Number 3. Bernard L. Madoff Investment Securities, LLC. Total scammed, $18 billion. With a link to the Ponzi scheme of Charles Ponzi, Madoff's scam was smart and cunning. Known as the most significant investment scam in history, our number 3 entry took money from investors and nonprofit organizations. However, cleverly, Madoff didn't take the money straight away. He took the money from his new clients to pay his older ones. He did this to convince his old investors that they were getting a fair return on their investments. Little did they know, this wasn't the case at all. Because of his scheming deviance, some companies closed down and others lost their entire livelihoods. Number 2. Kenneth Lay and Jeffery Skilling. Total scammed, $74 billion. If you've heard of Enron, you'd probably be familiar with this horrendous scam of all time. This American company came into the news in 1996 when their sales increased from $13.3 billion to $108 billion. Fortune magazine named Enron America's most innovative company, not one, but 6 years running. The company is reported to have employed over 20,000 employees and claimed revenues of over $100 billion a year. The truth came out, though, when the horrendous amount of debt had been proved to be hidden from investors and auditors on equal measures. Number 1. Bernard Ebbers. Total scammed, $100 billion. The CEO of WorldCom, one of the biggest telecommunication companies in the United States, was Bernard Ebbers. He accomplished this by hiring lots of little companies and building the business rapidly, which left WorldCom in dire straits. There was around 100 million people who owned stocks and bonds in WorldCom that lost around $100 billion when the company went under. Ebbers was held responsible and sentenced for this horrible deceit. He's currently serving a 25-year sentence in prison. Well, Aluxers, that's a wrap on the top 10 biggest scams in history. When it comes to scams, there are plenty of them, big and small, all around the world. Even in places like Egypt, where someone actually took stones from the Giza pyramids and convinced gullible tourists they were legit artifacts. Some of them even sold for up to $496, and it wasn't until a Facebook post that the public found out that the men doing such things were finally arrested. What a load of rubbish. What was the best scam you've ever seen? Let us know in the comments. And of course, as a reward for sticking with us until the end, here's your bonus all about identity theft. Our bonus fact for today is that everyone is vulnerable to identity theft. Just think of how vulnerable you leave yourself, or maybe you haven't even realized before. You go to work in the morning, you pay for your journey either daily or weekly with your credit or debit card, which puts you at risk of having your card information stolen. Simple things like going to the shops and getting a drink or the morning paper with your card are the same. All it takes is for one employer to install a skimmer into their card machine, and that's it. Your details are stolen. Stay vigilant, Aluxers. Keep those eyes open and never be naive. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxer. Make sure to subscribe so you never miss a video. If you want more, we handpicked these videos you might enjoy, or head over to Alux.com for the best in fine living content on the planet. Be a part of the largest community of luxury enthusiasts in the world and tell your story.